Holton is the area that we believe has been hit the hardest around our area. Laura Borchers live on the phone. Give us an update.
Yeah, we are seeing a lot of damage out here. And at this point, the emergency management team has kind of set a perimeter around Holton, and they're trying to keep most people on the outside here as they try to go home to home and check for anyone injured inside. They're checking the whole area to see if anyone needs help that has not yet received it. Here on the outside of the perimeter, there are a lot of families that are doing one of two things. First of all, a lot of people are trying to reunite. I talked with one woman who said she was just frantic to make sure her mom, who lives just a few streets up, was okay. So she was walking door to door to see if her mother was in one of these homes out here. So a lot of people are trying to reunite with family members, and others are chipping into the homes that we see right around here, trying to put things back together. There are a group of probably two dozen men from this area helping one homeowner out here try to put a makeshift blue tarp roof back on his home. His home is still intact, but the roof was just peeled right off of it. And so we're seeing this community truly just working together to try to pick up the pieces. The damage is immense. It's extensive. We're seeing parts of people's homes all over yards and fields. And as we know, there have been fatalities associated with this tornado that came through here. The emergency management team here has also set up a home, a temporary home, for those who are no longer able to get to their house at the county high school that's in Versailles. So if you are someone who lives in this area and you're hunkering down at one of your neighbor's homes, you can stay tonight at that high school, and they are anticipating quite a few people staying there. We still have no exact number on how many homes inside of Holton are torn apart, but as soon as we get that, we're going to get that information to you guys as well.
Laura, I know they're keeping you on the perimeter right now, and of course they have to do that for your safety and for theirs. They have a lot of work to do inside Holton. Are you getting a sense, is it as bad as we were hearing? People were saying the town was leveled, that it looked like a war zone. Have you talked to anybody who's been in there, who's come out?
Absolutely, Sheree. I'm hearing that, you know, one of the iconic parts of Holton was a church that was right in the center of the town, and one woman told me that it was just shredded, and she said that was just sort of the iconic portion of it, but around that, she estimated 20 to 30 homes, and that is nothing official. That's just someone who was inside there. She said that it looked like that many homes were just torn apart, and that's another factor of why the emergency management teams do keep everyone out, because on top of going door to door to check for each person inside this village to see if there is anyone that's trapped under rubble, they're also trying to make sure the village itself is structurally sound. There is a lot of debris and a lot of buildings that may look like maybe you could get close to them, but really there are so many buildings that are impacted that you just don't know how precarious the situation. But by all means, I feel like there is no way that this was overestimated. This town is deeply impacted.